So guys, staying on the theme of creating length in the spine, we're going to do downward facing dog. So we keep the distance between the hand and feet that we have found in plank, and we just lift the butt up and back to a downward facing dog. This is called hell pose if you're new, because your shoulders are going to scream, you're not going to be able to breathe, but you have to learn this pose. This is one of the best things you can do, and we do it over and over and over again. It's like our starter pose in every flow we do.
Sorry, I'm sleeping like a monk.
That's okay.
Okay. Is it okay if I stood or?
You can just grip the sides of the mat.
Cool.
No problem.
Are you okay?
Yeah. Alright guys, staying on the theme of creating length in the spine, let's do downward facing dog. So just lift your butt up and back and keep the distance with your hands and feet. And if you're slipping, just grab the outsides or just put a towel on your head or something. So, downward facing dog is, or downward for short, is the base and starter position of almost every flow we do. But in the beginning, it's not going to feel like a relaxing, it's going to feel like a hell pose to be in, but you just have to learn it to open your shoulders and create length in the spine. You can see that Miha bends his knee here. He's a smart guy, so he bends his knee to create even more length in the spine. Watch what happens when he straightens the legs. Whoop. The spine is affected. Do it a few times. As soon as he tries to get the leg straight, he rounds his spine a bit. Alright, he did this many times. In the beginning, you're more likely to be here, like a half plank, and that's going to be even more heavy and maybe rounding. So try to stick your butt up and back. When I help people, I do something like this. I push back, so you get a point to push back. Yep, you can see he gets the right length there. And if I want to help him even more, I can lift him up and back, so he releases the back. This feels usually very, very, very good for tight jiu-jitsu backs. Right, Miha, I'm gonna have you stay here for a couple of minutes. So, you should not be able to see your heels from here. If you look back at your heels like you should, they should disappear behind your toes. So you actually have to keep that toes in and the heels out action like we did in the first pose, the posture pose. Alright, knees can be bent no problem, because you're most likely going to get a nice calf and hamstring stretch even without straightening the legs. Okay, tailbone shouldn't tuck too much. If you tuck your tailbone a lot and suck your belly in, you're going to be completely round. Do like a cat, like round a lot. In some, and just round like this. This is probably going to be too much. So try to find a nice even length in the spine. Your head is going to help you with this. If you tense your neck, your spine is going to be tense. If you drop your head and relax your neck, maybe shake your head a little bit, yes or no. Yep. So this part, the traps and the inside, should relax. We're actually going to turn around so they can see better. You're going to turn the mat, and you're going to do it this way. Right. So if you're slipping, just grab. So this is the tendency to use the traps to lift. What we want to do instead is use the outside of the body to do this. So rotate your biceps forward, screw your hands down into the ground, and drop your head down so you actually widen the shoulders. So you can, yes, exactly, do that a few times. Yes, that and that. Squeeze together and relax. Yes, so it's not the top of the shoulders that you should squeeze together, it's the lower part of the shoulder blade. So drop your head down completely, spread your shoulders, and rotate. No problem, sir. So the elbows point back, so we're trying to do this, and relax this part, and engage the outside instead. Very nice. Help pose, you agree?
I absolutely agree.
But his spine is getting a nice relaxing feeling here while his arms working and his butt is pushing up. Alright, come down to your knees. We're gonna do it from the side again. So we're gonna do a motion from here. We're gonna go from plank pose to down dog, plank pose to down dog. Just slowly moving back and forth, just to get the feeling. Moving in and out of the pose will teach you the pose. So move back and forth. Slipping a little bit on the mat. A little bit slower, moving forward to plank, staying there, engage the legs. So you find the plank first, and then you take everything you found in plank and just move it into your new home, downward facing dog. Again, forward to plank, engaging the legs, chest forward, lengthening the spine, lifting your butt up and back, bending the knees, heels rotate a little bit out, downward facing dog. All right, sit down please. You will never master this pose. I've trained yoga for over 4 years and have so much to learn in simple poses like down dog, but it will help you tremendously. All right, guys? Good luck with down dog.